Siddham, everybody, and welcome to our last night of this Kartik Mass Gyan Yagya. Tonight, as we do our last session, I invite you to join with me as we do opening mantras. Tonight, we'll be doing Stotra to Lord Krishna as I present one last discourse. And in this last discourse, it'll focus on the value of what could be done, or what could you do for yourself by simply doing what we've been discussing for these couple of nights in this holy month of November, or what we call Kartik. It still has time before Diwali, after Diwali, there are things still happening before the month end. If we can be together again, we will do another session of satsang before the month finishes. This month doesn't just stop when Diwali stops. What happens is many people stop doing prayers around that time. But for example, at the Govardhan, tomorrow, in some parts of India, they celebrate something called Ahoy. And I'll send out more on that tomorrow. Tomorrow is that day, the Ashtami is tomorrow. On Facebook, on the group, in the WhatsApp. If you would like to know more about that, please look out for it. Please join the group on the WhatsApp, and you will have that information. I don't want to overwhelm you with too much information. Before we started this evening, I sent out pictures from prayers this morning, from my puja this morning, with the flowers, beautiful flowers. It was adorned. It was in one of the pictures, it was in a parai. In the other picture, it is an aswatic lingam, crystal looking like lingam, that is worshipped on a day like today. Today was the Saptami in the month of Kartik. Great day, wonderful day, powerful day to do puja. Tonight, in our discourse, you're going to hear about Lord Krishna, as we'll do short verse out of Bhagavad Gita before we conclude. Let's join together now as we set to worship Lord Krishna. As Satyabhama, we heard of Satyabhama earlier this week, we'll deal with her tonight in details for the knowledge and benefit of all. Om Gajananam Bhutaganadi Sevitam Kapet Jambo Palachar Bakshitam
Uma Suktam Sha
Kavinashkarakam
Namami Viganeshwara Parabhankajam
Sarva Mangala Mangalye Shive Sarvat
Sadhike
Sharanye
Trayambike Gauri
Narayani
Namostute
Om Namo Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
One more time, everybody. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai. Tonight, as we enter into Padma Puran, we want to hear more about Satyabhama. Satyabhama is considered in this text, he says, Krishna says, of all my consort, because he had gotten married, and you'll hear a little more about that, to eight girls, prayerful people, good people. And in the night when we were doing the Narak Chaturdasi discourse, the night before Diwali, when I explained about the Yam Deep and all these different things and why we do what we do, it is said that when he was going to fight that demon, he takes Satyabhama and Garuda and he goes with her. She is always close to him. And Satyabhama wants to know why. What is the history? Why do you allow me to always be so close? And why do you feel so strongly about me? What it is? What did I do, O Krishna? At some point tonight, she's going to ask that question. And the Satyabhama discourse raises a point that we need to acknowledge tonight. We always ask for more. We are always praying. We are always in need. You know, you have a $5 in your pocket. God gave you that. But dear God, thank you for the $5. Please bless me with $50. And one day God will bless you with that. But you cannot afford, my first point tonight, you cannot afford to be ungrateful. You know, with all respect, one of the worst words a person can call another person in our dialect, in our language, is, and I'm saying it for children to understand, please understand, I'm not being disrespectful. That word called nimakharam. Nimak, to understand what it is, nimak means is salt. That is the Hindi word for salt. And that word simply translates loosely for everybody to understand the imagery into salt teeth. Imagine if you never knew what that word was and you just hear people banter about it, they use it, but we don't know what it means. Imagine just for a moment, your mother made a huge pot of salt food, cooked food, good food, and everybody comes to my mommy to eat. And nobody took the time to say, Ma, thank you. Mommy, that food tastes good, girl. God bless you, Mommy. Thank you, Mommy. Then you are ungrateful. That is what that word means. And it is considered to be the worst sin in the Sanatan Dharma. Sanatan means everlasting, truth, the oldest, the really good one. Dharma, principles. That set of rules that guide a person in their life. Eternal rules, true rules, however you want to look at it. That is what that term, Sanatan Dharma. Tonight, in doing it, we will also learn about that flowers I showed you, Parijat flowers. Let's enter into chapter, I'm doing Padma Puran. Chapter 249 of the Padma Puran. Let's sing together. Tonight is going to run away from us, everybody. Let's get going. Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatma Namo Namah. Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatmaya Namo Namam. Mahadev Uvacha Rudrayeta Chakraye Ati Prasen Sartajitaye Ati Tam. Krishna, Krishna, ye dulab, dvijayate mrityuye yatam, narayanaya krishnaya, paramatmaya namo namah. Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki jai. In this section, Lord Shiva is answering questions that Kartik Baba Skand Baba is asking. Skand says, could you please tell to me, O Prabhu, who is it that Lord Krishna got married to? Who in detail? And how is it they were able to attain him, to have him as a husband? I have heard that even Radha could not get married to him when he was on earth. Did you know that? Radhika Devi, we heard the night when I was talking about Tulsi Mata, gives Tulsi, when she's the gopi, she gives her shrap and she says, you go upon the earth and become a human. But if you notice your Lord Vishnu, as you are very familiar with Lord Vishnu, when you look at Krishna Bhagwan, when you look at chapter 1, Bhagavad Gita, you will hear that when they went on the battlefield, Krishna takes out his sank and he starts to blow that sank. And it brings up a question, why do we blow the sank? Why do we have that shell in the hand of Lord Vishnu? But when I watch Lord Shiva, he doesn't have that in his hand. And it has to do with this same Radha Devi that Skand is asking about now. After Tulsi is given the shrap to come upon the earth, the Leela is set in motion. And one day, and I'm summarizing, one day, Krishna and Sudama, they are in Golok and they are going from place to place. And Sudama is with his Lord, he's in his glee. And he's going to see the universe according through the eyes of Lord Krishna. But Radha is waiting, and she's impatient. She wants to see him. And when she hears the noise of who she alleges is Krishna coming closer and closer to her bedroom, to the bedroom door, she opens the door with full force. But instead of seeing Krishna is standing this side. Sudama is in front of her. Very angrily, she admonishes him, and then she turns to Krishna and she says, you knew I was waiting for you. And so long you will take. And when her volume started to go up, Sudama, that devotee, that slave in his heart, anything Krishna tells him to do, he will do. Anything that Lord wants, Sudama is willing to do it. Sudama cannot bear. Put yourself in that position. Somebody is hurting somebody you love. He cannot bear to hear those words, that volume, that voice, the shrieking of that voice. He says, oh, you forget, Sudama now, you forget, woman, who you are speaking to. And Radha Devi, with anger in her eyes, red eyes, she says, you speak out of turn, you forget I am Adi Shakti Jagadamba, mother of this universe. How dare you speak to me in such a way? You speak as if you are a demon. You have forgotten proper etiquette and behavior. For this reason, Sudama, I put a shrap on you. Leave Golok and go upon the earth and become a demon. Sudama starts to cry. And Krishna smiles. Krishna tells Radha, my devotee will accept your shrap. And he will become a demon upon the earth. And I myself will go to deal with him, to receive him, to fight with him. I will go myself. Radha is getting more angry because now Krishna is going further away from her. Sudama actually puts a shrap on Radhika Devi after she had put the shrap on him. He says, you did not appreciate my Lord for 1 year. Not for 1 year, for 100 years. Sorry, Bhagavat. Go and live on the earth and never get him. Never be able to get married to Krishna. For this reason, Vrindavan Bihari Lala Ki Jai, it is a common misconception that Krishna and Radha get married. They grew up in a village together. But in some texts, they talk about her being a little older. so she would not have been suitable for his younger age. But they were friends and they would play. In that Bhagavat, you hear of Radha teaching Nand, teaching Yashoda. And when they teach, when they are taught something, they give something to mother. They allow time for mother. And Radha is spent in a hurtful way, waiting. For this reason, do you remember the discourse when I mentioned last night when Krishna is going to destroy Kansa, when he is leaving the house of Nand and he's jumping on the chariot to go to Mathura to meet with Kansa? He finds Radha and he says, Devi, what a pity of Krishna when in this form they are together. Watch Radha and Krishna right here. He has this flute. He's still living in Vrindavan. But when she was crying, she says, where are you going? Why are you leaving me? He says, Devi, I will never leave you. And he takes the Basuri and he says, here, you keep this Basuri until such time I return. When I return to you, I will take back the flute. Then we shall return to Vaikunth. We shall return to Golok. I have my work to perform and I am going to do it. So when Krishna leaves Vrindavan, watch the cover of your Bhagavad Gita. Watch your murtis when he is in the kingly mode, when he is in the battling mode. He has the Sudarshan Chakra in his hand, but he does not have the Basuri. Radha is the one who keeps the Basuri, and he is going now to do all that he has to do. Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai. But who is Sudama? Sudama is transformed into Shankachod. That is the name of the demon. That Shankachod gets married to the Tulsi, the little girl that got the shrap from Ganesh Baba last night when she's growing up. They get married and they learn to love each other. And it so happened that Shankachod became very devious, very bad. And Lord Shiva, all the devtas come and they beg Lord Vishnu, we have to destroy this person. He is very bad. He is causing havoc upon you. Lord Vishnu says, I can't touch him. He's under my protection. Lord Shiva says, but he does not pray. He does not observe any ritual. He does not observe any rites. And Lord Vishnu makes a strong statement. He says, that is the same Sudama, my friend, my devotee. But he has a great blessing. Although in this life, he is a great sinner. In his past life, all the good that he would have done has led him to have a good wife, a good consort in this life. And no matter what mistakes he makes in this life, this very ardent, straightforward, truthful, honest girl called Tulsi is taught by her mother what is appropriate and what is not. And she prays to me, O Shiv Baba. She prays very clear, very straightforward, not for herself, not for anything that she wants, but she's only praying for him, protect him, look after him, Lord Vishnu. And as such, I am a slave. My hands are tied. Do you understand this tonight? When you are talking to your God and you are talking with a pure heart, he says many times, he says, whatever that devotee wants, I have to give it to him. Because you are praying without selfish want. You are praying for other people. You are not praying for damage, harm, hurt, hinder. No. Even if Lakshmi Mata, when we were listening to the discourse where Ganesh, the elephant head, got the Parijat flower, he says, wherever Ganesh is, even if Lakshmi Mata does not want to come, she must come. So powerful is that flowers. You saw the picture on the WhatsApp, you saw the picture in Facebook. That simple flowers. He says, Krishna says, that is the blessing that individual had. Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai. They go And what Lord Krishna does? He has to distract her. Devi Bhagavat Puran, it describes at length that when battle had come and Lord Shiva is on the battlefield and they are dancing, the dance of death is coming, but Mahadev Baba cannot let go of that Trishul. Because of the prayer of Tulsi Devi, Shankar Chod is able to beat Virabhadra. He's able to beat and send Kali Mata, Dakshina Kali, all of them off the field. He is so powerful because of the prayer of this woman. Lord Shiva now is spinning that Trishul and he's ready and he's telling him, wait, you're dead. I am dark with the energy to come for you, O Shankar Chod. Your time on this earth is done. And he's smiling because he knows the power of the wife at whom Lord Vishnu went. Today I was talking, we were doing puja, and I want to mention this now as it relates to this Tulsi discourse. You know, sometimes young children today have cell phones in even satsang hall, even the temple, by the bedi, pling, 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 pling. And the old lady would say, listen, when prayer is going on, put down that phone. And somebody asked me the question. That's why I'm bringing it up. Baba, is it really wrong for me to check my phone, check my messages when prayer is going on? Depending on the message. Because this is the problem. If somebody, and I'm not calling anything on anybody, please be clear. Please be clear. For those of you in the local circle, Trinidad, those of you are around the world. When we go to do puja, we are usually standing on some leaf. If I'm the pundit, I'm telling you kush grass because of what it represents. You are praying, dear God, bless me that I must be able to do the puja and conclude my puja, get through my prayer. Okay? What's the big deal with that, Baba? Okay? Somebody dies in your family, do you know where you become unclean? Let's say today I was in puja and something happened to a member of the family at a foreign country or a foreign place or a different place. You become chutihar, you become unclean when you are informed of it, when you hear of it. In the case of a text, when you are informed, when you read it. So one of the reasons why, before cell phones were wrong, and even up to now, the person is doing their worship, do not interrupt them. The person, don't talk. Please, don't talk. Prayers is going on. Allow them to focus. And do not disturb that person's prayer. Because imagine we are halfway through the prayers, and I pick up my phone and I read the text. Oh, you hear Raja pass away. But Raja is my brother. So now what are we going to do? We have a problem. Because we are unclean. How do you offer the next parasad? How do you offer the flag? How do you do the havan when you are chutihar because of the death of somebody? For this reason, you do not let people or things interrupt you or distract you when you have a prayer. What is supposed to happen? Finish all the prayers and then find out, then inform, then do that which is necessary. Vindravan Vihari Lala Ki Jai. Lord Vishnu goes in the home and while Tulsi is praying, Prabhu, in the murti form, Prabhu, protect my husband, don't let nothing touch him. And Mahadev Baba is living on that battlefield, screaming and jumping and wailing and spinning that trishul, but he cannot touch him. And Lord Vishnu takes the form of the husband and he goes and he slaps the counter and he's knocking the kitchenwares and, Devi, I want food! And I'm saying it so for children. There's a little more detail for those of you that know this discourse. There's a few more details. But for children to understand, he's making a distraction. Come on, take out food for me, girl! I want it now! And the poor wife, thinking the husband is calling. Children, focus. Mommy is praying sometimes and daddy tells you, give mommy a chance, give mommy a chance. Give her a little 5 minutes. Let's just say she prays. Let's see what she does. This mommy is saying the prayers. And this person is pretending. Lord Vishnu says, I have to do this work. Because if the husband is allowed to continue, many innocent people will die. And he says, please come. Do not tarry. Do not waste time. I'm hungry. I want food now. And she stops the prayer. And as she stopped that prayer, as she stopped saying that prayer, she broke that meditation. And she comes out of that dhyan. Immediately, Lord Shiva let go of the trishul and took off the head of Shankarachuda. That head traveled from where the battle was taking place straight to the home of where Tulsi was. And when she took out the food, now Lord Vishnu is in disguise. And let's say the husband eat with left hand, with the roti and takari. But now husband eating, fake husband, is eating with the right hand. She saw it. And she said, hello, who are you? So Lord Vishnu in disguise says, I'm your husband. She says, no. I know my husband. I know his mannerisms. I am a faithful wife. I can tell you what he like and what he don't like. And right now, you are not my husband, and I want to know who he is, because I've been praying all morning. And if you know what good for you, imposter, tell me the truth before I give you a shrap. Lord Vishnu now, Prabhu, takes his true form, four hands, Shankar, Chakra, Gada, Padma, that four-handed form. And he says, Tulsi Mata, I've come to bless your home. And she says, very good. Why did you take the form of my husband? Why didn't you take this form as God to bless my home? Why this trickery? And Lord Vishnu has to tell her the truth. Your husband is now dead. Your husband has just expired on the battlefield. And if we did not kill him, dear lady, dear chaste wife, dear honest wife, dear faithful wife, a lot of people were suffering. Today I have caused you pain. And I apologize. But for the benefit of the world, I needed to do my work. One of the servants bring in the head of the husband and she starts to wail. See yourself in that position. She starts to wail. Bawl. Oh, what a cold God you are. The verses in Devi Bhagavat says, your heart is as cold as stone. Your heart is black. You are no fear God. My whole life, remember I told you in the discourse when she was 5 years old, she watches the mother praying and she says, Mommy, I want to be like you. I want to get married like you and I want to have that type of relationship that will take me to heaven if I practice what you are teaching me tonight. What if I practice what you are teaching me today, I will find God and I want to get married. Remember that whole discourse we did. She's hungry. She wants to get married because why am I wasting time? She says, since I was 5 years old, I have been begging you for a husband. When I get the husband, dear God, bless my husband. Let me keep my husband. And the one thing I prayed for. Remember, she was learning at the feet of her mother how to pray. Who taught you to pray? Who was the person who taught you to do this? You know, Baba have a big belly. And sometimes when you go to prayers, you see people holding up the belly. The belly falling. Hold up the belly. They don't know what is the proper way to pray. Have you ever gone to the church and seen somebody do that? Or to the masjid and seen somebody inappropriately use a prayer stance that is not in conformity with what is in the mosque? No, brothers. It's only in Hindu prayers. It's only in Hindu prayers, the fathers, they do like the belly falling somewhere by the jockey. Like you had to hold up something. Oh, Lord, hold up the coconut. It falling. And then we teach young children, do that. That is the example. Do just like your father. Yesterday, I was talking to a child, and I said, babe, you know, during this month, we could offer a little turban for daddy. Or daddy died. He said, what are you going to do that for? My father never offered turban for his father. I going to offer that for he? People learn, children learn from home. What you practice at home, that is what they will do in life. For the parents tonight, please listen, please listen. Tulsi was very hurt and she says, the one I learned from my mother was the value of marriage. The value of marriage. And I have tried my very best, no matter what flaws, because our husband was not perfect. Don't feel he was an angel, don't feel he was God sent. She said to me, and maybe this is the difference between man and woman, eh? Correct me if I'm wrong, I don't know much. You ask a man, that your wife over there? You're going to hear the man say, well, yeah, but you know now they just get fat after pregnancy. She a little maga. She a little big. I know she ugly, but what are you going to do? It is cooked good. That is how man is so. From my experience, you ask a lady, that your husband? Yes, that is my husband. And he's beautiful to me. He is all I need. A lady have a different way of thinking. And Tulsi is saying that that way of thinking, she mirrors her mother's prayer. And that prayer learned and practiced from a young age followed her into adulthood, into marriage, before marriage and then into marriage. So when people like Tulsi to put the pity in your mind for you to understand how a young girl is supposed to pray. Sita Mata in Ramayana, when she sees the feet of Sri Ram before the Swayambar, she runs to tell Durga Mata, Gauri Mata, I've seen somebody and my heart started to feel different. I've seen friends, I've seen my father's friends, that age group. But my heart never felt like this. Today I only saw his feet. I didn't lift my head to watch him in his face. And my heart started to feel different, mother. What type of worries, what type of chinta, what type of mental confusion is this? And why did she run to Gauri Mata on a Tuesday? When we have young ladies that are getting ready to marry, especially after the chekhai, or the engagement is done. You know the traditional sense in chekhai, in our dharma, chekhai used to be done to, and look at the intelligence of Hinduism and our people. If you have a boy and a girl, who is going to give trouble? And I'm answering a question now. Why do we do chekhai or engagement? The girl's family goes to the boy's home. This is a basic breakdown for how it goes. Ganesh Baba Puja is basically done by the groom-to-be. And the brother of the bride, coupled together with the senior men of the girl's side family, are there to witness it, as well as the senior people in the boy's family. And the reason it is done, for Rhea, who asked me this question, please listen, babe. If you live in your father's house and you are governed by the rules of your father, how much trouble you go give? In the home where discipline and daddy has a little say, daddy has a little authority in the home. So you cannot go frolicking with Tom, Dick, and Harry. I don't think the girl is capable of doing much under those circumstances. If the girl is brought up correctly, and she knows, as we were talking about modesty last night, she knows the correct way to carry herself. But the boy is totally, is as if we have separate rules in society for boy children. Tonight, I want to ask you, for all the mothers and daughters here tonight, is society fair? And the reason I'm asking this, the same ladies who say in society this judgery bad is the same ladies who just call themselves mother-in-laws and judge the poor daughter-in-laws when they're trying their very best. The same ladies belong to the temple and community center and say, yes, yeah, see, she come last night with sari and she's trying to play, she's sadwine. She's trying to play, she's swamini now. After she beat she body and she do all what she do and pull down she father name. So we never do. Only some do. Jai Vishnu. But remember, the way our society works, if the man, if the young boy have 10 women in the course of his single days, that's a macho man. International event he have, the red woman, he have the Venezuelan woman, he have Indian woman, Muslim woman, oh my God, he's an encyclopedia. That man could do everything, he's a good boy. Let the girl go and do that. And my godchild would tell you that she's lambast, she's a bad, what would they say? A bad thing. That's the language we use. Nobody else, you know, is our own people, our own family members, our own brothers sometimes. Lambast and hurtfully address women like that in a derogative way. The rules apparently are different. So when Sita Devi and women in that category, we want to align ourselves with somebody, the chekai is a means, a method by showing the boy's family and the girl's family as witness, his foot is tied. When people are getting engaged and the boy carry the ring and he go down on a knee and he propose and me know what and what they do. I didn't do all them craziness. What that give you? What that do for you? You ever see how people just do that? What security does it have that he will not cheat? In our method, at least the elders have a say. They are like the police. If he's going off, no. The brother, the girl's brother who is like the hero, he says, I come to tie your hand. Sorry if I touch the mic. I come here. The brother offers the ring. I remember when Nandi, my two younger sisters, the older one was married, and I didn't know anything about Chika. I was learning. I remember Sham did the prayers, and deceased pundit Vishnu Haribachan was the pundit. And I gave Sham the ring on behalf of Nandi boy, and he's smiling because he getting married. And everybody gave me kicks because they're saying, well, he look like two of them married in. And he gave me a ring box, and he says, take this for your sister. Showing commitment, showing, you know, love, showing the commitment not only of the boy and the girl, but also of the boy's family, that we accept this girl. We accept her. We accept this family. And we are committed that whenever we agree for a wedding, it will happen. Things do happen to throw off our wedding. I wouldn't say no. But especially when things could throw off the wedding, such as our untimely death or something like that, we need to have the commitment that the boy is not going to try to sow his oats or to impregnate some girl some way before he has to commit to this, you know, your relative or whosoever. People speak ill about our olden practices, but you see the day somebody hurt your child, then you got to start, oh, we should have checked Patra before we do the wedding. Oh, maybe we should have checked and see the best lagan. You know, the other day was at Digmas and Mommy Baba was laughing because I was wondering what kind of parents, knowing that a Digmas is bad for wedding, all pundits saying it. You're going to do wedding in a Digmas? Very good, that your child. You make it straight away. Good. But you know what they're going to do? As I told Mommy Baba, when they in trouble, Baba, somebody do we opia boy. Baba, do some prayers, Dina boy. If they have prayers for stupid yet, you know, devotees. Sometimes Gita tell it, you are your own friend and you are your own enemy. Don't forget that. Don't forget that. Tulsi is the person, just like Sita, they grow every Tuesday as they are walking. After the engagement is done, they advise, young ladies, please, every Tuesday, Mangala Gauri Puja, Mangala coming from the word Tuesday. There is a vrat that you worship. Mother, please, if my marriage is only supposed to last for 20 years, double it, make it 40 years. Mother, if I'm not supposed to have children, if I'm supposed to fail, Durga Mata in that Gauri form, please make the impossible come possible. Mangala Gauri Vrat, ask your Baba about it. Why take a chance with your children and your grandchildren and your wedding? Do you know in Trinidad and other parts of the world how many Hindu people are getting divorced? Because the ways we used to have, how many people in our circles could say, well, we are celebrating 35 years marriage, 45 years marriage. Those days, those things are done. They are gone. If they last 1 year, last night after satsang, I was on the phone with a young groom who I did the wedding for. But parents, oh my God. Teach your children you did not marry for 1 day. I just always tell mommy, Baba, good, bad, or ugly, that is my wife. I love my wife. Listen to what this stupid pundit saying here tonight. Whether the roti bun, whether the roti thin, it fat, she laughs at me because she make good roti, everybody. Everybody go feel as in, she don't cook good roti. You see, she has to sit down here with me and let me talk this. You want to sit down behind camera. Eh? Whatever it is, that is my wife. Don't feel me, and I am admitting here tonight. Look, Anushkadi, let me be honest with all you. I am not perfect. When you see I looking for a book or a paper or a tablet or even my glasses, I, mommy, Baba, if all you come, for those of you that know this ashram, this woman don't rest. We had our trials in the beginning. And my father-in-law, I could say it. I'm admitting this tonight. My father-in-law sat me down and he says, brother, I expect better from you, you know. Come on. And I can't, to be honest, I can't say nothing bad about my father-in-law and my mother-in-law. Salt of the youth kind of people, always planting, always bringing something, loving people. The best decision I make, if I give her a joke, how? Again, mommy, Baba. I didn't know how to ask. I was nervous. And I went by them. And I did not come back from New York, so I did buy the ring. I said my prayers and everything. And I really know. If this girl tells me no, I'll be dead. The day I'll be dead. My drummer, well, in them days, me moving alone, you know, I'm outside with my drummer, my organs. When we finish the prayers and everything done, you know how you get your panchamrit, you get your parsad, you get, she laughing. You get your panchamrit, you get your parsad, you get arti. Well, this is how it went. Panchamrit, parsad, here, this is for you. And the arti, I'm only telling you this, I don't want to tell nobody. That between me. And that was the proposal, and I must admit that in my case, at least, that yes, I get to share, me and mommy, Baba, to sit down and talk to all the weddings we just do. We just sit down and talk to people. We don't know everything, and we have not faced every obstacle, obviously. But in our own way, we try to counsel and help. I don't speak to anybody alone, because it's probably easy to come by. My wife is everything from my now to my secretary to my driver, and by the grace of God, what I want to say is getting married to this girl was the best decision, I made. But you see, what make it the best is the training she get from where she come from. Who trained she? I wasn't there. We assume parents. But she was grown up in a very, up to now, very close knit, a web of family. This auntie and that auntie, and when them talking, well, partner is this auntie and that auntie, and you're just hoping you could remember somebody's name because you know your Baba have a very bad memory. But in their family, it is true that everybody had a say, had an input. And I could see, I get the prize. Because when this girl come, she changed my life for the better. Tonight, consider what I say. Are you proud of your choice? Do you pray for your choice? Do you sit down and say, dear God, we did together, you know. We don't buy the expensive ring and spend all the money on the whole wedding and all the raw and everything. Keep me away from divorce now. Keep me far away from that D word. Everybody is afraid of the F word and the C word. But trust me, that mommy Baba just opened she and she wanted to know what I'm saying that for. What's the truth? Mommy, look, he just said the F word. Which one more detrimental, the F word or the D word, divorce? When you don't have happiness in your life, when you can't laugh, whatever you have, you have to fight in court. Don't talk about children. Don't go there. Don't talk about custody. I'm doing prayers for a family. And in the family, if the children, I think the eldest is like standard 5 years old. And the middle one is about 4 years, maybe four or five years, somewhere. And crying. I remember in the Ramdad family, Ashti, as I talk about this little flashback in my mind. Children is cry when they have to go and separate and go to court, and they're forced to go by a parent they don't want to go by. As you all know, everybody wants to stay by their mother. Not in every case that they say the mother better than the father, but sometimes responsible people make a difference in a child's life. And then the court tell you, well, you have to go. That might seem to me, in my life, in my experience, in Mom Baba case, it seems so alien because we didn't grow up like that. In my case, when we used to get to come up by my grandmother, me I want to see mother, me I want to see father, I only want to see my friend and them. I get away. But when I go by my grandparents, that was my joy, that was my happiness. Whether it was plum, mango, plum today, chow was the way. And you grow with that happiness, you grow with playing. Children nowadays do have that. They do have that. Tulsi Mata comes from a home where she was taught how to pray and how to fight and how to make it in marriage. Sudama is incarnated, yes, as the husband, but he has ways that test her. But she stands up to the test because the old saying is, you don't marry for one day. You know, in the vow it says, don't grudge me when we have little friction. As you understand the other person, as you think when I get married, I didn't cause trouble. Man, I throw in the kurta so, and I throw in the towel so, and now come this young girl and she vexed because I am so stink. You have no reason to lie to you. I'm telling you from my own life, my own testimony. And then you realize, you know what? When you love somebody, you do what you have to do to please them. And especially in the case of a man, you try. So if it means sometime you could pick up after yourself, if it means you could help in the kitchen, you want to do it. Nobody had to tell you to do it. And Shankar Chow became that kind of person. He was a warrior and a beast outside for all the fight. And then when he came home, he was like melted butter for Tulsi. And she used to pray for her husband every day. Asking her again, do you pray for your wife? Do you pray, dear God, COVID going around, dear God, my husband had to go to work, God protect him. But you know Diwali coming up, and when Diwali come, Jai Lakshmi Mata Jai, and you're going, man. But every day, it ain't no dear in a little marriage, it ain't no light in a little marriage. but it's supposed to work magically now, Baba. I don't pray. I can't pray for my spouse. I can't do that. But let me matter how to snap your finger and do all the work and make everything perfect. Marriage takes effort. That is one thing I learned in my own life, and then from spending time with my grandparents who are married for many years. My grandfather now died, and he died a few years now. My grandmother's still alive, and as I was talking in the satsang, if you watch on the YouTube, you'll see the satsang we did last year for her birthday. And she just still remember fondly in those days, because she's 80-something now. In those days, Cain, he was a Cain farmer, and they were a little more well-to-do family. And they had a shop up New Grant, and he used to go in the shop to buy one hack sweetie, just with a chance to see the girl. And that was the love story. That was it. One day, he man up, and he played brave, and he come and he asked she brother, asking the girl that asked the elders, I come to ask for she hand in marriage. And she brother didn't accept it. Frank comment, he said, you're too poor. Where you go push him? And my grandfather just always tell me, since then, he said, brother, make sure your education, you make something of yourself, don't let nobody talk to you like that. And when people talk to you like that, it's hurt you. And how they end up married in still? Because everybody have a story. He come back to buy hacks, he come back to buy hacks, and she mother was watching. And the mother tell the big brother, well, she, my grandmother father had died. So the big brother and the mother was in charge. And the mother says to the big brother one day, Carmel, let me see where that boy living, let me see that house. In those days, this car had shared and, you know, different living quarters for indentured laborers. And my nanny, that my nanny mother, lectured her son. Sometimes when you're married people, you don't marry for the pocket, son. You marry them for the quality, for the ways. And Patsy, that my grandmother, Patsy is going to marry this man because this man loved my child. This man will treat my child with respect. This man don't drink. This man don't carry down himself. This man, that is our son-in-law. So said, so done. And as a city, I can't remember how many years they married. But they married for long. God just send people in your life. God just give you that story. Unfortunately, for some, you're divorced. May I say no to that? Even Sri Ram and Sita Mata had to settle, separate at the end of their story. When we talk about dirty matter with that Narakasur, Sita Mata leaves the children of Ram and she goes into the earth, never to be seen in that form again. That is part of it. Karma is real. But when you want something, you have to know how to work for it. Tulsi Mata was working for it. And she turns and she tells Lord Vishnu, no matter, I was ardently praying and I was begging you for one thing. Not for me, and I was praying for my husband. You as God, so cool that you would take that prayers and show me that my prayers have no value. The one thing I was praying for, Lord Vishnu, you're still a gemate. You're cold as a stone. Today I put a shrap on you. Just as how my husband, Shankachod, has left me and I am crying. Oh, Prabhu, go and take the form of a black stone and leave your spouse in heaven, Lakshmi Mata. Come upon the earth as a black cold stone. Lord Vishnu takes the shrap. Diwali morning, for those people that will be joining with me, to do puja for Lakshmi Mata, there is something called a Lakshmi Sankh and we'll be worshipping it. Look at the hands of Lord Vishnu, Lord Krishna, that Sankh is always there. Govardhan Day for people who have numerology problems, people who are praying for the land to probate, to settle in court, all these different things they do on Govardhan Day. You would see seashells being used in puja, Vasudhara Puja. it is used. Mario Baba now roaring with his army on the battlefield, four hands. He lifts up the headless body of Shankarachuda and he's about to throw him in a pile of fire burning on the battlefield. And Lord Vishnu says, wait, Shiva Baba, give me that body. That is my Sudama. Let us throw him in the sea. Let us throw him in the water. Where does the sun come from? It comes from the bones of Sudama. He says, my devotee, let him go in the water, and from his bone, let all the shank come. Shankachur, shank. And this is why Lord Vishnu has that shank in his hand. That is the love he holds for Sudama, for the devotee that prays for him ardently. Since that day, all the seashells, small, big, crustaceans, different things, all these things came from his body. And for this reason, whenever puja is being done, the reverberation of that sang, the body of Sudama, runs negative people and negative things. Vindravan Bihat Lala Ki Jai. Satyabhama is achieved. Somebody asked, how did he get married to Satyabhama? There was a king by the name of Satrajit. I'm reading from Padma Purana. This same Satyabhama who went on Garud with him to fight Narakasura in our discourse the other night. And Satrajit gets a very big gem from Surajnarayan Swami. And this gem is as if the Samantak gem is as if it has trapped the sun in the gem, the way it glows and, you know, it's sparkling like a light. And he gives it to his brother Prasin. And every day Prasin, when he's coming to court, when he's going, wherever he's going, everybody is oohing and eyeing as they are watching this beautiful gem. And in Padma Purana it says, so happened one day Prasin went to hunt as a Kshatri, and a lion attacked his party, and the lion devours him, kills him, and takes, well, you know, maybe in the eating or whatever, the gem goes. Jamwant, the bear in Sundarkand, in Jwalaprasad, Tulsidas, Ramayana, whichever version you have at home. Jamwant at the very beginning of Sundarkand is the one who has the task and has the darshan. They remind Hanuman, you have the power within you to accomplish this task. Jamwant the bear is told when Sri Ram is at the bank of the Surya River, when Ram Gita is being given, he says, you wait upon me. You wait upon me until I come back upon this earth and I will play with you. I will give you darshan. I will come to you. And Jamwant had been living in a cave waiting from Ram Janam. He's waiting. One day Vishnu Bhagwan will come. My Ram will come. Now Jamwant is in a family way. And he saw the lion close to the cave. So this great bear destroys the lion in fear that it would harm his family, his children. And when he had, you know, they take off the skin for warmth and so on in the forest, they took off the skin of the animal. Within the animal, he found this gem and he brought it home. And the gem is a toy. He gives it to his small one. And the small child is playing catch with it. It is no value to him. It is just something daddy gave me. In the court of Krishna, it is said that Prasen, the younger brother of Satrajit, the person who has the gem, he has been missing now for days. And the question is asked, Krishna, did you kill this man? You know, he has something that is valuable. And it is so great. It is so mysterious. Is it that you, O Krishna, O Kanha, that you, O great emperor of Dwaraka, that you became so jealousful that you wanted to have it for yourself, and he did not want to give you it? Is it that you have killed him now? Tell us the truth. When people look at the moon on full moon night, when people look at the moon, when it is the Ganesh Jayanti, the Chaturthi. And what is going to happen, people, it is told in Ganesh Puran that the person is going to be falsely accused. Krishna was experiencing this problem. You know, in other people culture, look at the moon, the full moon. The moon is so full tonight. As a Hindu, you never do that. And if you do it, what is the remedy? Om Shri Ganeshaya Namah, Om Gam Ganapataya Namah. Please remember that. Krishna has found himself now, false accusation. His own people that once loved him has now turned on him. You are a murderer. You have usurped that gem by unrighteous deed. He says, no, no. O people of this city, no, I have not done that. And they instruct him, those in the court, the ministers. O king, if it is true that you have not killed him, go and find him and bring him back. And when searching, following blood and other signs of difficulty, Krishna was hunting and searching for Prasen. And he found the remains of Prasen. And then he searched for the lion, and then he found the remains of the lion. And as he's going now, as if Jamund had dragged whatever he took, the skin, the head, the mane of the lion. Following that trail, he comes to the cave of Jamund. But outside the cave is the son of Jamund, a little boy playing. And he's playing, tottling with the gem, tottling with it, catching it like this. And the little child says, he says to the little child, little one, where did you get that? Where did you get that gem? Where did you get that jewel? And for those of you living abroad, like the Singh family in Denver tonight that is looking on, Sintra from Texas, Cindy from Houston, for those of you that in the park or in the state parks where you have grizzly bear, black bear, when you see the cub of the bear, I remember I was in Alaska one summer, and we were in a park. We had gone climbing, rock climbing. Them days, your baba was thinner. And we did not pay attention that two young cubs, brown bears, grizzly bear, had crept up where we were. They were still at a distance, but fairly close still. You could see them. And the danger is, if you are not close to them, but they come to you, and you interact with them, you try to feed them, you try something, harmless intentions, the mother becomes very protective. That is the living instinct of this animal. And we were there in Denali Park, and as our eyes saw these little cubs, the next question was, where is the mother? And when you turned around, imagine you pitch road, and we were climbing off the road. Car park here, and we were off the road. As we watched up the road, over 1,000 pounds of meat is running full speed, coming at us, jumping the car and move. Krishna is talking to a young bear cub. He's in danger, and he doesn't realize it. The bear is sitting, the mother, sluggish, hibernation-type sleep, is right there watching. And when he saw this form come with, you know, the bow, the arrow, the sword, Krishna is a warrior, come close to that cub, Jamund immediately, in that parental protection, that type of mood kicking, and immediately he roar and he rushes at Krishna. Fight start. And for a period, in Skand Puran, they say for 12 days, in Padma Puran, they say for 10 days, day and night, the sun is coming up, going down, and they are fighting, and they are fighting, and they are fighting, and they are going like that. Krishna and Jamund continued to do battle. And as they became tired, Jamund became tired, when he blinks and he watches, he is not seeing Krishna. He's not seeing this form. But he sees Sri Ram. Madhya da Purushottam. Sri Ram is standing. He's holding Ram like this. And in that moment, it was as if his body became limp to see his Lord in front of him. Krishna, in standing in front of him now in the form of Sri Ram, he said, Jamund, you didn't make me out. Jamund, didn't I tell you I was coming to play with you? Jamund drops to his knees and he says, Prabhu, forgive me. Forgive me for my misstep. Forgive me for attacking you. Dear God, I did not know it was you. Dropping his head at the feet of Krishna, he cries and he thanks him for giving him the what? The darshan. Just allowing him to see. Just allowing him to see that form. Immediately, Jamund knows that he is saved. He's going to Vaikunth. When he takes out the Pankajaya Shank, Krishna bellows that Shank, just as he did in the first chapter in Bhagavat. In that Parva in Mahabharata where the Bhagavad Gita comes from, that Shank echoed in that forest and the soldiers looking for Krishna found him. And Krishna goes back to Raja Satrajit and he says, I did not kill Prasin, but look, I am returning the gem to you. Now when Krishna was leaving Jamund says, please accept my daughter. Please bless my family and accept this girl so that our family would be blessed to have a son like you. Jamunti is married to Krishna. And when Krishna goes back to Satrajit, he says, may the glory of my house be uplifted, O Krishna, O glorious king, by you marrying my Satyabhama, that is his daughter. And Krishna is happy to marry that girl called Satyabhama. It so happened one day, as Padma Puran continues, that Narad Muni had come and he had come with some great amount of holy and auspicious flowers. And Krishna is giving to all the different gopis, all the different girls, everybody, Rukmini, Jamanti, the mother of Samba, and all the others, but he forgets Satyabhama. And at the end, he tells her, oh dear one, I am sorry. So when the discourse happened with Narakasura and they were leaving there, when Satyabhama goes to the house of Indra to talk about the fight and they sit down, Satyabhama saw the flowers that I put up, the Parijat flowers. On the day when they are churning the ocean and the flowers comes out of the water before Tulsi Mata, Indra took the flowers. Satyabhama now wants the flowers and she says to Kanha, may you please get those flowers for me. Krishna and Indra fight. And Indra says, what is the benefit of these flowers coming to the earth? If they retain in heaven, all the devatas will be blessed and they are capable of keeping these very potent flowers. And Krishna says it here, and I just wanted to read this particular line, that the person who is able to worship with the Parijat flower, the person who is able to offer the sticks from the Parijat tree, the person who trims and culls and maintains this tree, it is as if he is doing my seva. And let it remain upon the earth so that when my children, my devotee, my loved one wants to worship me, let him use this flower. Let him in the month of Kartik use this Parijat flower with its very fragrant nature, the flowers, the leaves, everything about this plant. Once it is offered with love, I am very happy to receive it. Therefore, O Indra, let it go on upon the earth. Vindravan Viharilala ki jai. And Indra, he submits. After the fight, he submits. And Krishna, now the happy husband, brings this exclusive plant and very calmly plants it in the courtyard where the home of Satyabhama, where her apartment is. Oh Satya, Do not be angry with me. Look, today I am making repatriation. I am asking for forgiveness. I am doing that type of deed to gain your favor. Don't be angry. He says, Devi, she's wondering, how did these flowers come? I know this is living in Indraluk. He says, me and Garud went and we got it for you. One feather of the Garud had fallen, and from that feather came the peacock, the mongoose, the blue jay, things that do not tolerate snakes. Krishna goes to the apartment with the plant in Dwarka where Satyabhama is, and Satyabhama is saying, tell me how it is that I am so blessed to attain this desire yielding tree. Do you know that if a person prays with that flowers, what you are asking for, you are going to get it? And then, the real question, could you tell me what did I do to get such a spouse, to get such a husband that you would fight heaven and hell, earth and back, to give me what I want in this life? And I'm saying this tonight because if you have your problems in your marriage, listen carefully. Stop trying to cut your wrist. Stop trying to drink Gramazone. Do you know how many times I, as a pundit, when those blessed security guards, the other day I saw a pundit talk about it in Facebook, in text, but all in my different. I am not afraid. Right is right and wrong is wrong. We go with dhoti and kurta. Other priests go with their garb and they are not stopped. There are people dying on the ward, women who are pregnant and they just want to say a prayer. And with our good heart, there is no money involved. It is just service to mankind. We are going there to pray for people, children, dying people, cancer patients, diabetic patients that are going for surgeries. And these Johnny-come-lately police wannabe officers that are on the steps, some, not all. Hello, you can't go there today. No, who are you? Are you the doctor? In front of people, these people that are seeing gurus and pundits that are trying to help and pray for people. If the CEO of San Fernando General Hospital is watching tonight, I am begging you to intervene. Because people still need to pray. Maybe in some people's mind, COVID is taking out a God. God is gone. So in Trinidad, you could sit in a cinema. You see, Movie Tongue say they're going to close down Trinidad. They're going to close down Trinidad. The girls, them in HR in Movie Tongue. One threat Mr. Chin made, I'm closing down cinema in Trinidad. And did you hear today? Cinema, the concessionary stand, you could eat now. It's okay. 2 weeks later, you could eat. You will not get COVID. The rule was before, sit in the cinema for 3 hours. You're safe. Sit in the temple, the church, the masjid. This is not only me as a Hindu, but think about it. Sense make before book, right? Sit in the cinema for 3 hours, you're safe. Sit in the place of worship for 1 hour and let a minute pass, you're in danger. It have a certain trend. Open all in-house dining. But the poor people who trying, and I mean, to be honest, the people are really undergoing some difficulties. The bar owners and these people that are trying somehow to make a sale. Everybody have to buy a laptop now. Everybody is looking for a way. But some people don't go in their business place. Some people, no problem. It is fine. Go. So it comes just like you could go in the sea, don't get COVID. But don't go by the river. COVID living in fresh water, I go kill you. Don't do that. Remember, don't do it. But you see, when you go in the hospital, I am telling you, if I don't talk about it, if we don't start to discuss this is going to cause trouble. Before COVID, I used to take the members of the ashram and we used to go. People used to say, Teddy Ramsay, God bless you, I'm trying to get in contact with you, find me, come on. Teddy came, other people came, many people came. 85 people, we walked the ward and we was giving out water, rose to women on the ward. It is not about money, it is just about, you know, service to man, praying with people, holding people. You feel we only hold Hindu people hand or Indian people hand. Our intention is to pray. And a security guard, no matter we are talking about going for pass, temporary pass, visitors pass, the attitude, the way they speak to us, the way the person spoke to me, it have a God, and I am begging the people that are working these wards, please understand, just as how you have family and you have relatives that sometimes need prayer or just need a kind word, please don't rob sick people of that prayer that could be the last prayer, that could be the last moment. Don't do that. Things are not well in Trinidad. And you see San Fernando General Hospital? That is one canker sore that needs to be looked at from many angles. Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai. Satya Obama says, how is it possible that a person as low as me can get a husband as great as you? What did I do in my past life that you, the other day, I told you for the saving of women, Christian got married to these girls that were kidnapped. In those times, there is no social service, social worker. There is no understanding of how people treat women today. In India, in some places, a widow is somebody looked down upon. She's looked at as baggage. So at that time, to prevent that pain, Christian steps up as a politician, and he does more than he's expected to do. Satya Obama says any one of them could be my replacement. All of them could be my replacement. But instead, you're going to battle and you're putting me on Garud. You come home from battle, you're coming and resting your head on my lap alone to give me your full story and to listen to my advice. Oh, Madhusudana, what does a woman, what does a man do to get a spouse like this in this life? Please tell me. Tell me so that others could know how to have happiness like I have today. I saw Parvati Mata begging and praying to get Lord Shiva. And it was not easy. Oh, Krishna, please tell me what happened in my past life. And in this 88th chapter of the Padma Purana, he tells her that in a different cycle, in a different sansara, when Satyuga had finished, in a place called Mayapur, there was an old Brahman named Dev Sharma. He had a daughter named Gunanidhi. These people, Gunavati, and these people were very devout to sun worship, solar worship, Suraj Narayan worship. Dev Sharma did not have a son, but he had a godson by the name of Chandra Sharma. And he decides, as time has passed, as Gunavati had come to age, to get them married. And he says, oh Chandra, from today, I consider you my son. And Chandra, in turn, looked upon the father as that type of fatherly figure, and would treat him Charan Sparsh. He would touch the feet. Sparsh is to touch. Charan is the foot. And he would bow to the feet of his father-in-law as if it is his father. Krishna says together they worshipped all the forms. When it was Ganesh time, did Ganesh. When it was Devi time, do Devi. And in that way, life was good. And they continued. At one time, Krishna says, son and father wish to go chapter 89 now. Son and father wish to go to collect material to do yagya. And they go together into the dense forest, thinking that they would come back quickly. Both of them are attacked by a great demon. And being, you know, Brahmin people, being unarmed, practicing non-violence, not trained in the art of war and the science of weaponry, were quite helpless. And very quickly they are destroyed. They die. And word reaches back to this young daughter and wife that everything that you hold near and dear has been destroyed. And she starts to cry and she wails how unlucky she is, and as a woman, how helpless she is. And then one day she gets the strength now when all the different rites are completed. And Gunavati does two fasts. Till the day she dies, she maintains the breath of Ekadashi and the Kartika Mass vrat. For the pleasure of Mahavishnu, for the removing, she says, whatever sin I have done that I would lose my father and my husband in this way, I am going to offer deer. I am going to plant tulsi trees close to the front door. I am going to water tulsi tree, and I am going to fast during this time and do worship. Lord Krishna says, Satyabhama, you do not know, but in that birth, that girl would water every tulsi plant, would talk to the tulsi plant, would offer stress, tears when she's crying to that tulsi plant. And when she's worshiping, she does arati for me with the sankh. And she's praying for help and betterment the next time she comes upon the earth. And one day, when she is in that swoon, the life is about to come out of her body, a chariot is seen, a flying vehicle is seen descending from heaven, and all the people in the chariot look like Lord Vishnu. And they come with cowries, things that are reserved for great gurus and the king to fan and to maintain in those days, before we had air condition. Thank God for air condition. This was the air condition. But it was a sign of, you know, royalty. The aeroplane lands and the whisk and the curries come out. And all the attendants come and gently lift her up. And the soul comes out of the body. That Jivatma, Shuksham Sharid, is allowed to go into the vehicle. And with all grace, with all love, with all everything, she is transported to Vaikunth. All the attendants, they work and they answer only to her, whatever needs she might have. When she goes there, she meets with the Rajan Satrajit. Dev Sharma, Chandra Sharma. Gunavati is standing there and she's asking, oh husband, what are you doing here? And they tell her of the happiness, about the blessings of having that tulsi plant growing at your home, worshipping, not spitting, not urinating, not in any way damaging that tulsi plant, but working with that plant, bowing to that plant, putting flowers. Devotees, tonight I am telling you, please remember, bow by that tulsi plant when you are leaving home. Chandra Sharma tells her, thank you for always keeping my head upward, held high because of the pride of the type of wife I had have. In this life, you in death have taken care of me, have taken more care of me and my soul than if I was alive. Gunavati says, oh husband, what did I do? What seva are you referring to? And the Chandra, the husband, says, because the month of Kartik did not waste on you the vow, the worship, giving gifts of the deer, what we talked about last night, observing the vow, doing practicing of Jap, Havan, like what people will be doing on the night of Diwali, to maintain and to strengthen the power and potency of your mantras. For those people that are coming by me, if you would like to come, please, I still have one or two places. Come on. Diwali morning, we have the day before Diwali. For those people that would like to join with us in Tarpan and Shraddh. And then on the day after Diwali, we have two small groups. And people are coming in those 10-10 groups so that they could do Govardhan Puja with the Swatik Lingam. Nursing Shaligram. All these things are going to be there. It is only for you to want it and to make up your mind that I want to see change in my life. He says, oh, my dear one, O Satya Bhama, that Gunavati is you. And because you made full use year after year of that Kartik, that month, Ekadasi Brat, but the Kartik, when you died, you were reborn as Satya Bhama. And because of your pure love, my dear one, you attained me as your spouse. And this is why today I try my best to please you. Because of the ardent prayer you offered in that month of Kartik. Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai. Time is running out on us tonight. And before I conclude, I want to just let you know that if you are seeing problems in your marriage, because not everybody has it easy, not everybody has it nice, and I agree with that. There are things you can do, there are prayers you can say, there are fasting you can do to change your karma. To change your karma. When you are seeing different types of difficulties, when you're going through different types, when the husband are being frank with you, when the husband watching you, there's a discourse where Gauri Mata is changing to Kali Mata. And Parvati Mata, when she goes close to Lord Shiva, he says, you like this form. Go back to the pretty form now. Gauri means the beautiful one. And Kali means the ugly one. She's too dark. She's ugly, and Lord Shiva shunned that form. Parvati Mata got angry and she says, you don't understand the body of a female. The body of the female is never stable. It is always changing. When she's a young girl, she looks one way. And when she makes children, she will look a different way. That same body will get older, will get stretch marks, will get different types of blemishes. But that is the same Adi Shakti. That is the same woman. That is the same wife. And if you really love somebody, men today, according to your dharma, you cannot love somebody when they're 19 and when they get 40 or forget them. But what we have is a society where maybe because of the addiction to pornography that we have, when the girl you're married in, she's so honey rat, oh my God, you couldn't get enough kuch kuch hota hai. And when she gets a little older and her body gets different, well, you know, half of Venezuela coming in through the boat in Maruga, and everybody have margarita by their house. And you would not believe how many marriages and relationships are in trouble because of that little difference. And I am begging you who are watching me tonight, please have a little integrity in your marriage. Have an integrity, because you are one day going to have to face God. And when you sit with Lord Krishna and you ask him, what did I do to get that beautiful woman or that great man that I am married to? And you hear something good, please let the other person be able to say the same about you. Please keep your head high. Please live truthful. What did we say the other night? I don't have the money to probably flag funded. I don't have the money to buy all the different sweets and light a million deals. But in this month of Kartik, a person could fast from lies. A person could just practice for the next few days. I'm going to be truthful. I'm going to be honest. I'm going to be straightforward. So what I mean is, don't hide your phone. You know, when you're texting whosoever on WhatsApp and you want to cover down the phone, when the girl telling the husband, I'm going down the road to meet my friend, and you're telling your husband, is your friend and your other friend. Sometimes we have to get back to the truth, and I am begging parents, please. Chapter 1 of Bhagavad Gita says, when the mothers of the home drop in their teachings, in their examples, then We are in Kali Yuga. Tonight, please clasp your hands, everybody. As I'm just going to do a couple of verses, time has run away. From chapter 17 of Bhagavad Gita, as per tradition, as per requirement, we are always told to read Gita before we close. To calm the place, to give blessings to all souls and all ones that are indeed need of help, to bless the Basma. Shiva Om, Shakti Om, Hari Om, Narayanaya Krishnaya, Paramatmaya Namo Namah, Narayanaya Krishnaya, Paramatmaya Namo Namah, Anoya Dvijakaram Vyaka Satyam Priyahitam Chayate Swadhyaya Vyasantan Chaiva Vandamayam Tapa Upachit Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatmaya Namo Namah Narayanaya Krishnaya Paramatma Yenamo Namah. Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai. Chapter 17, verse 15, 1-5. Listen. What is the austerity? What is the penance? What is the vrat of speech? Words which do not cause pain, annoyance to others. Insulting words, hurtful words. Those that are truthful words, agreeable words, or beneficial words, words that will encourage somebody, help somebody better themselves, as well as those words that are primed with the study, with the teachings of the Vedic and Sastric books, those that are filled with that divine knowledge, those words that practice or come from the practicing of chanting the name of God, then this is what you call sattvic speech, or fasting from your language, your words. It goes on to talk about what is the austerity. What is the austerity of your mind? What is austerity of the body? Tonight, as I conclude, I just want to harp on one thing. I don't have money and I can't do much. COVID is limiting me. Then we could try to be truthful in your marriage. Tonight, as Lord Krishna declares to Satyabhama, by doing this simple vrat, a person is able to attain happiness in marriage. So I will tell you this tonight. If you are having problems currently in your marriage and this month of Kartik is not done yet, it is not late for you. Give me a call tomorrow. Send me a message. And let's start a work. Let us start a fix what you cannot do on your own. You want help, and I would be able to help you if you only make the step to me. Tonight, as I conclude the yagna, let's chant one verse to Lord Krishna in the Madhuram Ashtakam. Mummy Baba loves this prayer, so I have to read this for her. Gitam Madhuram Pitam Madhuram Bhuktam Madhuram Suptam Madhuram Madhurade Patare Rakilam Madhuram Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Govindaya Bhyo Namah Om Shri Vishwa Vishwa Devaya Bhyo Nama Pujitam Pratishtitam Sayankal Bhyo Namam Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya Govindaya Namo Namam. As we conclude tonight, I remind everybody, make full use of this card to get ready for Diwali. I hope you learn something in the course of these simple 5 nights. I hope you remember what we discussed, and I understand it's a lot. Young Anushka is going to place these videos for us on YouTube. By next week, it will be up. And for those of you in the Cayman Islands, for those of you in St. Martin, for those of you in British Virgin Islands, and Canada, US, Europe, and you want this information, please just subscribe and you'll be able to get the information. You'll be able to comment. You'll be able to ask questions. You'll be able to benefit from these things. And I am making myself available. You know, everybody like to beat the pundit. Everybody says these damn pundit and them don't teach, man. Take out that from your head tonight. That excuse is no longer applicable. It takes a lot of energy to read these books and to find the information in such a way that we'll be able to reference the information properly, to do it the proper way. And I thank God for people in my life like Pandit Anand, the Dharmachar of New York, all the pundits of the IPC, Pandit Krishna from Sisters Road, Pandit Rajan, as I mentioned, he was the guy who was, and still is, I could call and we'll discuss Anand Ramayana and other texts. He taught Hindi. What did you think about Parisad or Parsad and Prasad last night? Some people never heard those things. Don't talk about Tali and Taria. Tonight, as I conclude, if you have any other questions, I'm begging, please send your comments, send your questions. Forward this to other people so that people will be able to benefit. Many people don't know about me. Many people don't know about these texts. Many people don't know about Kartik. They don't even know what Diwali is about. Tonight, as I conclude, may God bless you. May you please accept all that I have done and all that we've read and all that we have tried to teach. And may you learn from it, better it. And until we get to meet in satsang again, which might happen before the month is over, please continue to send me questions and let's communicate. There's a link to join the group on WhatsApp. And I am challenging you all to join the group so that we could really go around the excuse. The Baba them don't teach. They doesn't have nothing to teach. It is only going to sing asana and sing. Pundits are damned if we do and damned if we don't. If we teach, oh God, he's teaching too much, he's boring. If he sing and he sing too much, oh God, he over singing now. I guess you can't really please the public 100%, but I am trying to please my God. And sticking with the topic of Kartik in this month, I have done discourses that I thought would benefit you. And I hope I have done that. I hope I have given to you the knowledge that for some did not have. And for some, now that you have it, you'll be able to do what you must and do it better based on what we've talked about in Gita. Tonight, I thank you for your listenership, for all of you that have left your comments and your kind words, your love, your questions. May God bless you that you could continue to send your comments. I want to congratulate those of you in the United States that this long wait for a president-elect has come to an end, and now we have to work together to bring that country to whole, to oneness. No more Republican, no more Democrat, no more this race and that race, none of these things. We are one. And I encourage that those of you that are living there, please do not get carried away with those people in Texas that had the incident this morning. Please don't get carried away with those people. Everybody has their side, and when one side lost, of course there are going to be tears. And in this election cycle, it have harshness, it have coldness, it have racial attacks, etc. I am just saying, as a priest, as your pundit, as your guru, as your family friend, please let better sense prevail. And now that the election is coming to a close, although there are things still happening, we have a president-elect. And I am begging that for the peace and the tranquility and the safe transition, my dear Hindu brothers and sisters, we are one. Let the United States remember it is one. And the entire world is looking on. Please don't do any separatist or any decisive or separative type of activity. No attacks. No, that is not Hindu. Hindu is following ahimsa, a non-violent theory. May God bless you and God bless your homes. May you please, please practice being responsible. Please wear your mask. Please wash your hands. Please sanitize. Please be, if you don't need to go out, you don't need to go out. Be very careful when you're going in your taxis. People don't sanitize the door handle. Bear that in mind. Bear that in mind. Everybody is fatigued and we want to go back to normal, but the virus is still here. Please don't be foolish and be normal. I saw in Queens, there are Barahian, there's satsang and, well, all type of satsang. Nobody's wearing a mask. In Philly City last night, people attempted to do a Diwali program, and that is blessed, that is great. But please, leaders, managers of temples and so on, please remember we are still in a pandemic. Encourage, please don't be the person who has an event at their place or their temple or their community place and somebody dies, God forbid. Somebody gets sick because they came to your place. Don't do that. Please encourage responsibility. As soon as this virus is controlled and gone, we will revert. But I don't think I could face somebody knowing that their child gets sick or dies, God forbid, coming to my Diwali program or my program on the whole, to my sports day or whatever it is we have. I wouldn't know how to answer, why did my child have to die? I am begging you. I am begging you, please. Please, tonight as one family, let us be responsible. Together, everybody, please clasp your hands as we do. Final mantra. Twameva mata chapita twameva twameva bandhu
chasaka twameva
twameva vidya
dravinam
twameva
twameva sarvam mama deva deva
twameva sarvam
mama deva deva.
Come on, everybody, together. Final. Umapati Mahadeva ki jai, Pauna Putra Anumana ki jai, Shri Adi Shakti Mata ki jai, Vrindavan Bihari Lal ki jai. Jai jai Sitaram. Sitaram, everybody. It was a wonderful experience spending these couple of nights with all you. And I really appreciate all the messages and all the questions. Keep it up. You're doing a good job. Please continue to message. Please continue to send in your questions so that you, again, this is for you, would be able to teach your children and grandchildren the writing so they would know what is to be done. Again, Sitaram, everybody, remember to click on the notification button so you'll know when next I do my video. Remember, subscribe to the YouTube channel. For those of you watching this on the replay, join the YouTube station and may you continue to get the necessary information that you need. Okay, everybody. Until next time, Sitaram.